What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCPRO DIY. Today, we're going to be working on a 2011 Audi Q7. Today on the Q7 behind me, we're going to be covering how to do a rear differential service. We're going to be using 2 liters of our genuine Volkswagen fluid. It takes just over 1 liter, about 1.3 liters to be exact. So we're going to grab 2 of these just to be safe. This is also going to come with a drain plug and a new fill plug. You always want to replace those whenever you're servicing your differentials or transfer cases. We recommend that you do this service about every 50,000 miles. The Q7 behind us has 107,000 miles on it. It is absolutely due for a service. But before we get started on this job, let's take a look at some of the tools we're going to need for this DIY. For this DIY, we're going to need a couple basic tools, starting with a 3/8 drive ratchet, an 8mm hex, a torque wrench to torque everything down, and a fluid transfer pump. If you're in a tight area, sometimes you can use a wrench that's the same size as your hex bit to break free the drain or fill plug when you can't get a ratchet in there. So we'll have one with us just in case we need it. Now we know what tools we're working with, let's get started on this DIY. Boom, baby. We're under the Q7. We're gonna go ahead and get started on draining our rear differential. Just like any other vehicle, when you're doing a differential or a transfer case or gearbox, you always wanna make sure the vehicle's level. That way you get an appropriate level in there. Now we have our dip situated. We have our fill plug and our drain plug. You always wanna correct the fill plug first. That way you know you'll be able to A, get the plug off, and B, be able to fill it after you drain it. It's a little tight back here. We can't really fit our 8mm socket, and we're gonna go ahead and take an 8mm wrench and just put it around our 8mm hex bit. Then we'll use a second wrench to give us some leverage. There we go. Once we break that free, we should be able to get the rest of it off by hand. If not, we'll just reuse the wrench some more. Beautiful. We can go ahead and pull this all the way out now. And now for the bottom, we'll just use a ratchet and 8mm hex socket combo. We have more than enough room for that. And we'll drain this out. We have our catch pan situated below us. Beautiful. This doesn't look too terrible for 107,000 miles. We're gonna go ahead and let this do its thing for a minute or two, and then we'll grab our new drain plug and fill plug, as well as our fluid, and get ready to fill this up. All right, my beautiful people, this has completely finished draining. We're gonna go ahead and clean that up a little bit and install our new drain plug. Again, these are the same 8mm hex bits as the old ones. Everything's nice and oily and slippery. Now that that's snug in there, we're gonna go ahead and torque it down to 26 foot-pounds. We have our torque wrench ready to go. Beautiful. With that situated, we can now take our transfer pump and our fluid and get ready to fill up. Now we have our transfer pump and our liter of fluid situated. Let's go ahead and feed the end of our fill tool into the back of the differential. And we're just gonna pump it. We're more than likely gonna have to break into the second bottle. So I expect it to take this full liter, but we'll see. It all depends on how much came out, the temperature of the fluid when it came out. If it's a little bit thicker, it might be hung up on some of the walls and the gears, so. All right, we've pretty much maxed out the first liter. We're gonna go ahead and set up with the second one. Just give us one moment. All right, we are at about 1.3, 1.4 liters. While this drips out a little bit, I'm gonna go ahead and spin the back wheels a bit just to kind of get any potential air bubbles out of there. Let the gear suck up the fluid. She's slowing down to a dribble. We're gonna go ahead and give it just a few more seconds, slow down a little bit more. It's still a little over full. And then we're gonna throw our new fill plug back in. Now that our fluid has come down to a steady little drip, we're gonna go ahead and install our new fill plug. And again, these are the same 8mm hex. This one we're gonna do by hand. We're not gonna be able to get our torque wrench up here, but since it's the fill plug and not the drain, it's not consistently submerged in oil, we're not too worried about it. We'll just snug it up nice and hand tight. I love it. Now we can clean it up and button up this DIY. Beautiful. And there you have it, my good people. Another DIY in the books. Overall, a pretty straightforward one, but definitely a good one to know and a good one to do. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave them in the comment box below. And if you like this DIY and you want to see more like them, please consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.